I already built up a little name for myself because I was writing graffiti since 83. People did give me commissions for flyers and record sleeves. A friend of mine asked if I could do sleeves for him, and this was for a techno label. It gave me complete freedom. Yeah, do what you want. And because of that opportunity, I started to work with collage, actually. I wanted to try and see what would happen if I would cut up the drawings in different pieces and I would put them back again. A little bit how electronic music works as well. Yeah, cut up like little sounds and put it together and see what happens. Things took off around the time that I met up with DJ Food, who commissioned me to do work for a sleeve he had to do for DJ Vadim.
The piece behind me was made for DJ Vadim's album On Ninja Tune. It's again one of my favourite sleeves I've ever designed. Still to this day, get people remembering that to me. Fantastic piece.
He started to work more abstract, and the letters became less important, and it was more about form and the depth that is created with the layers of wood.
It was about 97 or 98, and I was researching the book that would eventually become Scrawl. The research had led me to hide out of Strictly Kev. I remember there was this one sort of small canvas he had, and it absolutely fascinated me. It was graffiti, but it wasn't graffiti. Who the fuck did that? I just remember saying that. I decided on the spot that it was going to get a double page spread in the book.
So around that time, this book Scrawl came out. I think that book was a good jumping board. That's when things started rolling. I went to this gallery in Seattle in 98, Houston it was called. I did those Sony capsule toys. Through Mama Gallery in Rotterdam, I was introduced to Maurer architects. And also, I was introduced to Yonohara from Japan. He brought me over several times for collaborations with fashion brands or exhibitions. Then Lisa, of course, who came to my studio somewhere in 2005, I think.
We had a friend working for Nike in Amsterdam, and he said, you should try to get these t-shirts by this guy, Delta, he's huge. We started digging with Rafael, and we found out who Delta was, and we called him up and asked him if we could sell his t-shirt. And here we are, about a bit more than 10 years ago, and we've done quite a lot of projects together, shows at the gallery, fairs, or the Biennale in Charleroi. It's never been a pressure to work with him because there's an exchange, so we grow together, and hopefully it will last 10, 20, who knows, more years. That would be great.